Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding finally action on bad loans. That is in the form of a question mark. Now the writer TT Ramohan is raising a question that is government taking some action on the bad loans. That is in form of question that whether the efforts that the government is making, are they sufficient in dealing with these bad loans or not? Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we must know about non-performing assets. And secondly, why the NPAs, they have grown. The reason behind the growth of NPAs. From 2005 onwards, Indian economy witnessed a good growth rate. Now, because the economy was growing at a good pace, the banks, they were providing a lot of credit to the private sector. Now, this credit that was provided to the people, to the corporations, to the institutions, this was provided without checking their credit worthiness. And this is one of the reasons that this NPA, they have really increased a lot. Now, when it comes to the problem, when this problem got identified, is another important aspect about understanding this entire issue of NPAs. Now, NPAs, they were taken care of from 2005 till 2010 because of the growth of the economy. But after 2010, there was a kind of a slump in the economy, and the economy could not touch the two-digit growth rate that we were prospecting. That we were believing that the Indian economy will be touching this growth rate. And in order to rectify this entire situation of NPAs, now NPAs, they are almost about 12% of the total loans. Now this year's economic survey has put the figure to the 9%. So the total loans, the 12% loans that the banks, they have given to the corporations, to the institutions and in the individuals, there are chances that they might not be returned. Now, there are chances that there might be a kind of a default on these loans. Non-performing assets, they have already been declared because the people are not paying back the loans. And we have another category of loans that is known as bad loans. Now, these bad loans, they are considered to be those loans on which the government believes, or the banks, they believe that they will not be getting back these loans. Now, because banks, they are an important engine of the growth of an economy, because they provide fuel to the economy in the form of credit, it is important that their economic health and their economic viability remains. Now, how can we strengthen this economic viability of the banks? Now, this economic viability of the banks can be strengthened if the government will be implementing certain reforms. And what kind of reforms I'm talking about? Reforms in terms of how the banks are being managed. The management of the public sector banks is a big area of problem. Now, why it is an area of problem? Because there is a lot of governmental influence. And because government generally adopts populistic measures, it tends to give loans to such people who don't have the credit worthiness. And this is one aspect that was highlighted by the PJK Naik committee. Now, the PJK Naik committee has highlighted this aspect, and it has recommended to set up Bank Board Bureau. Now, it is the Bank Board Bureau that will be deciding about who should be appointed to the management level of the banks. that who will be holding the top positions in the public sector banks. Now, when it comes to the issue of the NPAs, we have the public sector, we have the private sector, and we also have the foreign banks. But this disease is afflicting with higher intensity in the public sector banks. And in the private sector banks, the intensity of this NPAs is actually less, and it is least in the foreign banks. And this is one reason why PJNI committee has recommended to institute this bank board bureau. But this is only one effort that the government has taken to address this issue of bad loan. There are other efforts that the government has taken. Now, the effort, like, government is proposing to set up this PARA, Public Asset Reconstruction Agency. Now, this agency has been suggested in this year's economic survey. This agency will look at the bad loans of the banks, and it will suggest how to do away with these bank loans. Now, when it comes to the negotiation process with the people who are on the verge of defaulting on the bank loans, now the bank officials, they generally abstain from indulging in any negotiation or asking them to pay a lesser amount what they can, because they fear that the Vigilance Commission or the Comptroller and Auditor General will act against them. So it is important for India that it should be instituting agency like PARA as soon as possible. And the new legislation in the form of bad loan legislation should be enacted, and this legislation should create a body in the form of PARA that can, by way of negotiation, resolve this entire issue of bad loans. Now, there are other efforts that the government has taken in the form of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act, IBA. This is another area that needs to be effectively implemented if the government desires to do away with this issue of bad loans. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes, or you're interested in joining the online classes, or you're interested in joining the offline classes. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.